Good morning, children. Let us study the lesson Deep Water in detail. This is the third lesson in the main course book Flamingo, and it's written by William Douglas. Now, here in this lesson, he recounts his childhood experience and he tells us how he has conquered the fear of water. And he also tells us he was nearly drowned in a swimming pool. And later, all those experiences that he had in his childhood had deep influences and he developed fear of water. Over the period, he decides to conquer that fear of water. What does he do to overcome that fear of water? That is what the writer narrates in this lesson, Deep Water. In this story, William Douglas talks about his fear of water and how he finally overcomes it with strong willpower, courage, hard work, and firm determination. So, what you have to study is his childhood experiences due to which he developed fear of water. And later, due to his willpower and determination, he conquers that fear of water. So once he took courage, the fear vanished. That shows most of our fears are baseless. Fear creates dangers where there is none. So this is what you have to remember. The writer's experiences further confirms the proverbial truth. Where there is a will, there is a way. The kind of efforts we put in, in order to get rid of fear, that shows that he had determination and by any means he wanted to get rid of that fear. Introduction of the writer. Remember, it's a true account. It's an autobiographical account. Therefore, we should know about the writer. William Douglas was a famous personality from America. He was a leading advocate of individual rights. So, William Orville Douglas was an American jurist and politician. He was born on October 16th. 1898 in Maine, Minnesota. After doing graduation, he taught for 2 years in a school in Yakima. So he worked as a teacher for 2 years. But soon he got tired of this job and pursued a legal career. So later on, he became a judge and is a longest serving judge in the history of court. Douglas was appointed to the United States Supreme Court at the age of 40 and served for more than 36 years, longer than any other justice in the court's history. So that's why he's the longest serving justice in the history of the court till now. Both on and off the court, Douglas was outspoken in support for individual rights. So that's why he was a leading advocate of individual rights and for preserving the natural environment. He died on January 19, 1980 in Washington, D.C. Remember, William Douglas was a leading advocate of individual rights. He was a judge at the Supreme Court of USA, and he was the longest serving justice in the history of the court, as he served for 36 years. What is the theme of this chapter? What does it talk about? The chapter Deep Water is an essay written by William Douglas, in which he shares about his fear of water and how he overcomes the fear with courage, hard work, determination, willpower, perseverance, and a strong desire to learn something, swimming. So he had a strong desire to learn swimming. He wanted to enjoy fishing and canoeing, and therefore he decides. And due to his willpower and determination, he is able to overcome that fear that he had developed in his childhood. The theme covered in this chapter is fear and his triumph over it. So fear and how he conquers that fear. So conquest of the fear. It conveys the idea that fear is a great obstacle to our happiness and progress. It is a negative feeling which we can overcome by sheer willpower and optimism. So if he decides and then if you have got willpower and determination and you continue to come out of that, definitely you'll be able to conquer that fear. That fear can be of any kind. Let it be fear of water or height. There is no problem. You can always overcome that. But what is required is willpower. Where there is a will, there is a way. Now let us open the book. So keep the copy of the textbook Flamingo with you. And now let us start this chapter. So Deep Water, that's a third chapter in Flamingo. Then about the author, what is given there? William Douglas, 1898-1980. So he died at the age of 82. He was born in Maine, Minnesota. That's in America. So he is an American writer, a politician, an advocate of individual rights, a judge, longest serving judge. After graduating with a Bachelor's of Arts in English and Economics, he spent 2 years teaching high school in Yakima. So Yakima is in America. However, he got tired of this and decided to pursue a legal career. And later he became a judge. He met Franklin D. Roosevelt. Was Franklin Roosevelt? He was the President of America and became an advisor and friend to the President. So Douglas was a leading advocate of individual rights. He retired in 1975 with a term lasting 36 years as a judge and remains the longest service justice in the history of the court. The following excerpt is taken from Of Maine and Mountains. So this book is written by William O. Douglas. So what is the name of the book? Of Maine and Mountains. So here we find an autobiographical account. So this is his real story, his own story. So he is narrating his own experience when he was a child and then how he had developed fear of water and how he overcame that. It reveals how as a young boy, William Douglas nearly drowned in a swimming pool. He was nearly drowned, and that he narrates that experience too, that as if he had approached the death and how he came out of that. In this essay, he talks about his fear of water and therefore how he finally overcame that fear of water. Notice how the autobiographical part of the selection is used to support his discussion of fear. So there are some words and expressions that we come across. Let's try to infer their meaning from the context as we go on studying this. But just before that, let's read these expressions. Treacherous. What does treacherous mean? Treacherous means dangerous. Now here, what is treacherous? What is a dangerous? Think over it as we go on reading the lesson. Subdued my pride. Subdued my pride. What does subdued my pride mean? That we have to find out. What does subdued? So how did he subdue his pride? How did he overcome his pride? How did he suppress his pride? How did he not care for his pride but spoke? Then flailed at the surface. Flailed at the surface. So that also we'll see, flailed at the surface. What does flail mean? Fishing for landlocked salmon. So salmon is a type of fish. So salmon, that fish which is landlocked, which is there in that particular area. So misadventure. So adventure, but it's a misadventure. So this can be very risky. So this was a misadventure. So what is that misadventure? That we'll study about that. Bob to the surface like a cock. How he has come to the surface like a cock. So when you open the cork of the bottle, what happens? With lot of sounds, with the kind of action it does. So he had decided to bob to the surface like a cock. And then, was he able to do that? Was he able to come up very fast? That's what we'll see that. Curtain of life fail. So curtain of life is drawn. Probably he thought he's going to die. He is dead now. So he thought like that. And when one approaches death, the kind of feelings one will have, that's quite interesting. And he narrates that experience. Very interesting experience he narrates. And you'll find that which he talks about death, very, very interesting. Back and forth across the pool. So there is a shallow part and then there is a deep end. So there is a shallow end and then there is a deep end. So usually those who are beginners, what do they do? Those who are novice, those who are beginners, they will be swimming or they will be learning at the shallow part of the swimming pool. And usually those who are good swimmers, they will swim across the length and they will be going even to the deep end of the pool. So back and forth across the pool. So all these expressions that we'll try to discuss as we come across in the textbook. It had happened when I was 10 or 11 years old. So here the writer is narrating his experience when he was a child. He was 10 years old or 11 years old. I decided to learn to swim. So he wanted to learn to swim. He wanted to learn swimming. He wanted to learn swimming. There was a pool. So there was a swimming pool at the YMCA in Yakima that offered exactly the opportunity. So he was living in the town called Yakima. And what is the name of? It was at the YMCA. YMCA is Young Men's Christian Association. So that's an organization, and this organization, where there was a building there, their swimming pool was there. Now YMCA hostels are there in India in many places. The Yakima River was treacherous. This Yakima River was quite dangerous or quite deceptive. And here he did not go to Yakima River because that Yakima River was considered to be very dangerous. Mother continually warned against it and kept fresh in mind the details of each drowning in the river. So she used to tell, oh, so many are drowned there in the river, so it's quite dangerous, don't go there. And therefore he thinks that the swimming pool is quite safe. So, but the YMCA pool was safe. It was only 2 or 3 feet deep at the shallow end. So for swimming pool, there'll be shallow end and there'll be deep end. So here the shallow end was only 2 or 3 feet deep, while it was 9 feet deep at the other. So those who are learners, they will be learning there at the shallow end, and they can even stand there. There is no problem of drowning there. Only the problem comes only at the deep end. The drop was gradual, so the slope of the swimming pool was gradual. I got a pair of water wings. So if you want to learn swimming, you may buy water wings, or you'll use water wings to learn swimming, and went to the pool. So he went with water wings to the swimming pool. I hated to walk naked into it. He was very thin and he never wanted to just wear probably only short and go for swimming or swimming. And show my skinny legs, show my very thin, skinny means what? Very thin legs. So he never wanted to show his legs, but I subdued my pride. So he tries to suppress that pride, tries to overcome that pride, and did it. So he decides to go and learn swimming. From the beginning, however, I had an aversion to the water when I was in it. So he had aversion, he had a kind of dislike. Now why he had aversion to water? This started when I was 3 or 4 years old. Now he goes back and he narrates to us his childhood experience when he was only 3 or 4 years old. And father took me to the beach in California. His father had taken him to the beach in California. What happened there? He and I stood together in the surf. Surf is foam there. They were standing there at the beach. There it was a foamy water. I hung on to him. Hung. So he hung to him. Yet the waves knocked me down. And he was quite young. He was just 3 or 4 years old. So he fell down and swept, and the waves went over him. I was buried in water. My breath was gone. I was frightened. He was scared. Father laughed, but there was a terror. There was a fear in my heart. So it was a very terrifying experience for him at the overpowering force of the waves. Because of the powerful waves, he was terrified. He was too much scared. So here, what did we learn? So here William Douglas had innate aquaphobia. He had fear of water, and this handicap would have marred his entire life. It would have spoiled his entire life had he not chosen to confront and defeat. So he decides to confront that. He decides to defeat that. In this autobiographical account, Douglas details his struggle to learn swimming. The foray into swimming was punctuated by many harrowing incidents, one of which nearly pushed him to the edge of death. However, the never say die spirit of Douglas brought him the triumph against his aquaphobic weakness and made him an accomplished swimmer. So that is what we are going to learn in this particular lesson.